Good morning and welcome to St Mary's on this Wednesday for our Eucharist. After my debut last week, when I thought I did very well, until Richard woke up and took over, our bishops convened a meeting at the cathedral and decided it couldn't be allowed again. So they've asked one of the very top people from the cathedral to come down and take our service today. So it's lovely to be able to welcome Reverend Canon Philip Banks to lead our service.
Thank you. Yeah, you really set me up there. It's very nice to be with you. You know why I'm here, because of course Chris and Joe went on holiday to Spain. And I was just saying to Colin that I had a long planned holiday the same week. And of course then lockdown sort of unlocked and we all thought it's fine to go away. I went to Cheshire on a narrowboat, which was fine. As you know, dear Chris went to Spain, which meant that they've been quarantined for 2 weeks, which is a real nuisance. The other thing to tell you, this is not private now, is that dear Joe's father, 94-year-old, died very suddenly and unexpectedly on Friday just gone. And so in addition to the complications they're in, dear Joe is in quite a state of bereavement at the moment because his father and he were very close. So pray for them too. As we pray for the people of the Lebanon at the moment, the situation in Beirut is just terrible. I mean, you've seen it on the news. So we bring all these things to the throne of the heavenly grace. And I gather we start with, at least if we're not singing a hymn, because we're not allowed to, the tune of a hymn. So I'm going to hand over to Richard. So we meet here in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
So together we draw ourselves into God's presence and say the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you, and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we call to mind the things that separate us from God and from each other, asking God's mercy and protection, love and peace for us and for his world. And so together we pray. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in what we have thought
in what we have said and done, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image within us. We are sorry and ashamed, and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and lead us out from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we give thanks to God for all his gifts and blessings to us, these words of the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are God, Lord. You alone are Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the collect for this week. Almighty Lord, everlasting God, we beseech you to direct, sanctify and govern both our hearts and bodies in the ways of your laws and the works of your commandments, that through your most mighty protection, both here and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. For the readings we sit.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, verses 1 to 7. The Lord says, the time is coming when I will be the God of all the tribes of Israel, and they will be my people. In the desert I showed mercy to those people who had escaped death. When the people of Israel longed for rest, I appeared to them from far away. People of Israel, I have always loved you, so I continue to show my constant love. Once again I will rebuild you. Once again you will take up your tambourines and dance joyfully. Once again you will plant vineyards on the hills of Samaria, and those who plant them will eat vineyards, who will eat what the vineyards produce. Yes, the time is coming when watchmen will call out on the hills of Ephraim, let's go up to Zion, to the Lord of our God. This is the word of our Lord.
Thank you, God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus left that place and went off to the territory near the cities of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman who lived in that region came to him. Son of David, she cried out, have mercy on me. My daughter has a demon and is in a terrible condition. But Jesus did not say a word to her. His disciples came to him and begged him, send her away. She is following us and making all this noise. Then Jesus replied, I have been sent only to those lost sheep, the people of Israel. At this, the woman came and fell at his feet. Help me, sir, she said. Jesus answered, it is a right to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs. That's true, sir, she answered, but even the dogs eat the leftovers that fall from their master's table. So Jesus answered her, you are a woman of great faith. What you want will be done for you. And at that very moment, her daughter was healed. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
speak in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Do sit down. I don't know if you're used to a sermon on Wednesdays. I haven't prepared anything, but listening to that gospel reading brought to mind. Did any of you see the Netflix series only a month or so ago called Unorthodox? You should watch it. It's really amazing. It taught me a lot about Orthodox Jewish tradition. It's extraordinary. It's the story of a very young woman who escapes a particularly Orthodox community in New York. It's very moving. So Unorthodox, you should watch it. But what that brought home to me was how it is that this story you've just heard in the Gospel is in the context of a situation where a rabbi or a very Orthodox Jew would not speak, certainly not to a Gentile and certainly not to a woman. And that's what we see going on in that gospel reading you've just heard. And the disciples were presumably cross because the woman was being persistent and noisy, so perhaps they didn't like that. Maybe they were a bit misogynistic. But also, they were trying to send her away because she was not Jewish, she was Gentile, like you and me. And so they were kind of trying to protect Jesus because he was seen as a rabbi, effectively. And what this story tells us are two things. Jesus's inclusivity, both of women, but also of those who were not in the, you know, within the boundary. And it also tells us a story about persistence, doesn't it? Because she kept on at it. She knew that Jesus was a person of God. She knew that she would get through to him in the end. And so this story is also about us being, we need to follow her example of being people persistent in prayer, persistent in our faith, even when things feel like they're not going very well for us. We keep praying to God, asking God's mercy, his love, his protection, his peace. And then, of course, the third thing that this does is tells us that we are all included. We're included in the throne of the heavenly grace, and that we need to be very careful about putting boundaries between us who might think of ourselves as holy or special in some way. Yes, we have that magnificent faith which Christ gives us, but we need to make sure the drawbridges are always down, the doors are always open, that we're a place of inclusive love for all the communities that we serve. So our prayer is that we'll be persistent in faith, and it's to that God that we turn now in our prayers, drawing ourselves into his love. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for all the gifts that you give to us. The gift of faith, the gift of your Son Jesus Christ, light and life to us. We give you thanks for the gift of the gospel, the good news. We give you thanks for all who share the faith with us and help us in our life of faith and our journey of prayer. Help us to be persistent in prayer, asking God's mercy and love on us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so we pray for our churches at this time here in Haverhill, here in this county, all who seek to live out the Christian life in different ways in this pandemic through service and love in the community. We pray for all who serve the church today, particularly our bishops, and also who support them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we pray for your world. We pray for those in government making such difficult decisions. We pray for integrity and honesty in public life. And we pray earnestly for those affected in the Lebanon, in Beirut. There's many, many people who died and been injured. We pray that we might respond in love and in prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We continue to pray for this local community here, the communities that our churches serve. We pray for those who continue to work in the front line in so many different ways, in shops and supermarkets, those who keep our streets clean, refuse collected, especially those in care homes and surgeries and hospitals. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for those who are ill at this time, any known to us in a moment's stillness. We bring to God those who need God's healing touch, just as the woman in the gospel story prayed for healing. Lord, surround us, surround them, surround all who care for them with your healing and loving hands. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks for the communion of saints. We give thanks for those who have shared life with us here on earth, but who've passed through the gates of death, our own dear departed loved ones and friends. We give thanks for those who've been benefactors to us, who've shown us the faith and influenced us for good, but who've now died. We pray for those who have recently died, the souls of George Pinner, John Porter, and June Thurbin. And we pray for Joe Hawes's father, Charles Hawes, also recently departed. Rest eternal grant to them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Those watching from home know that peace comes to you from all of us gathered here in church. And here in church, we offer each other a sign of peace in whatever way is safe, and however you're doing that here at the moment. Peace be with you. And Wendy, you're going to sing an offertory song or hymn.
Thank you. prayer of the bread and wine. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Is it your tradition normally to stand for the Eucharistic prayer? If it is, do that. It is indeed right, our duty, our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty, Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is your living Word, through whom you've created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you've freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman, to die upon the cross, and raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you've sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit, and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you, as we say,
Holy, 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 holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts, bread and wine, may be for us his body, his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It's shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great High Priest, this, our sacrifice of thanks and praise, and as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, through him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. For the Lord's Prayer, we sit or kneel. So rejoicing in God's presence here in our midst under forms of bread and wine, we pray as Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share one brotherhood. And together we pray. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world.
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace.
So at this time, those watching or joining this service live streaming from home, know that as we receive communion here physically, we pray that you would receive communion spiritually in your hearts, in your homes, knowing that Christ is present at all times and in all places, bidden or unbidden, under forms of bread and wine or not. So our peace and our love come to you at home as we receive communion here. The post-communion prayer. Let us pray. Strengthen for service, Lord, the hands that have taken holy things. May the ears which have heard your word be deaf to clamour and dispute. The tongues which have sung or said your praise be free from deceit. The eyes which have seen the tokens of your love shine with the light of hope. May the bodies which have been fed with your body be refreshed with the fullness of your life. Glory to you, Lord God, for ever and ever. Amen. We use the prayer after communion.
Father of all, we give you thanks and praise, that when we still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home, dying in the glory, declared your love, gave us grace and the open gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit guides give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Do we have a hymn now?
Yes.
Are they on the screen?
Yep.
I'm kind of worried that we'll never sing again. I think it's legal and perfectly safe for you to hum your way through. I know some people are doing that. Please do. I can't encourage you to sing because that would be against the law. I'll let somebody to listen. But do hum if you like. So I'm really pleased that Chris asked me to come. It's been lovely to be with you all here today. I hope you have a good rest of your day, rest of your week. Good luck with wearing face coverings when you're here on Sunday, because that's the law from Sunday onwards, as you know. You kind of feel hot, as you know, if you're in the supermarket. So the Lord be with you on that. Perhaps I'll see you again sometime. I know you're expecting a new incumbent soon, aren't you?
Yeah.
For the blessing, stand, please stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, that peace which the world cannot give, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ the Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve.